Thousands of Valor residents have died after testing positive for COVID-19. The deaths unexpected.
And it really is hard to lose someone to a virus that really no one knew existed just a year ago. But the family you're about to meet ran into another problem. Here's Channel 5's Rudy Mireles.
Angelica Lugo was like a second mother to her niece, Krystal. Angelica tested positive for COVID-19 in October, leaving Krystal and her family lost.
So it was pretty much hospital, ICU, ventilator, and then she passed.
Out of safety, her family made changes to the prepaid funeral arrangements.
Attend church and, have a rosary and all those things that you have when someone passes away.
The morning of the service, they were given paperwork to sign. Burdened with burying a loved one, they assumed it was a formality.
And I didn't even think, to look at the different things on there because I had seen the contract that she had signed. And, I didn't think, they changed it,
But when they arrived here at Roselawn Memorial Gardens, it was more than a few minor changes.
They didn't even have anything to do with the viewing, which the viewing was the only thing we said we didn't want.
The Lugos called Channel 5 for answers, and we called Tamay Garza Funeral Home. Albert Vega says the pandemic has taken its toll on his team.
We have a lot of employees that came and go because of the pandemic. So, we had hired here just recently.
But he says being new is no excuse.
Either way, I want to reach out to them and have them come in.
Krystal says Vega called their family, and they got more than money back. They got closure.
They were apologetic, super apologetic, ridiculously apologetic.
In Brownsville, Rudy Mireles, Channel 5 News at 6.